My heavy facts got them running fast. Celebrity status rappers got no time for autographs. Money seen the blind a week, the gullible inside the glass. Grandma started running when the Nazi gunman brought the gas. I need to get away, come across a money train. Win a lotto, lift the seat tomorrow instead of scraping change. Life is nothing but a dream, I need to wake up from it. Scarf schooled me when he told me that the world is yours and everything in it. So I did it, then became a boss. Problems everywhere, I just need to keep running. Keep touching paper, but the haters just keep coming. So I'm beat coming, hungry, need to eat something. Time my shoes, never look back, just keep running.
I'm just me being me. They counting me out, you think it's three in the key. I get that dust off the collar, cause when I bust off, it sounds like a gunshot. I'm short bus retarded, regarded as the best selected. You best respected, I'm a vet. You just talking out your ass like the pet detective. Hackin' attack, they carry round pumps like an asthma attack. Laughing ain't having it happen. Clips knows I'm just rapping to smack him when my arm leaves the jacket like a go-go gadget attachment. Sitting back in the seat of your master, just laughing, grabbing you behind the face until you happen to crash. An accident happened, so don't say that you was never born. I was born with a set of horns and some metaphors.
I was born in Toronto. Shortly after, moved to Montreal. After that, we came to Oshawa. After Oshawa, I moved to Atlanta. After Atlanta, I moved to Detroit, Michigan for like a couple weeks. And then back to Oshawa again.
Originally, I'm from Poland. Came here when I was 10 years old. Which was 94. Learned to speak English in about 2-3 months. My parents just put me right in the elementary school, and you know, so I just kind of learned.
Yeah, school to school to school, man. Yeah. Like that, it kind of affects you as a person because, like, I don't get too attached to people. Girls don't like that about me, but whatever. But it's kind of hard. Like, I've always had the mindset, like, how long am I really gonna be here before I'm gone?
Yeah.
What's the fucking point?
We had a buddy passed away a few months ago, Mike Delanouche, rest in peace. He actually came to me with the idea. He said, you know what, you and Rooks sound good together, because we have done feature tracks before. And he's like, you know, you should form a group. And then I had presented the idea to Rooks, but he was in a group with four other people. He was producing, recording, engineering, he was doing videos for everybody, writing little choruses, right? So he's like, you know what, I'm in the group right now, I can't juggle more. And then, you know, realizing that I have my own production team and we got a studio and everything like that, so we'll just get to be a musician.
Yeah, let me focus on my craft more than just trying to help out a bunch of people. He's got a bunch of people that are trying to help him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So, the name Black August, how did that come about? It's a very catchy name, I like it.
Man, a lot of people didn't like it, mainly because it's two white guys.
But it got a little sensitive, man.
Yeah, what I would say is if we were white August, that'd just be racist.
I love that.
No, but black actually is an acronym for bars, lyrics, and quotables.
Mm.
You know what I mean? We're a very, very lyrical group.
I got to say that cool drop real quick. I love that.
Yes.
I wanna see them on, you know, at least touring Canada. and open up big name artists, you know, and selling thousands of records. Yeah. I think that's an achievable goal for where they're headed right now.
Yeah, the way they're working right now, to keep that up, sky's the limit, really.
Yeah.
Maybe black with some sort of other colors involved.
Yeah.
The whole top floor is all snapbacks, right? There's
okay.
A couple of two-tone ones
to check, yeah. Got one shot, just one life, with one chance and one mic to prove them that I'm one of a kind for just one night. One
strike. I'm trying to get some more black.
One right, one tight verse, killer with one line. Got one shot, just one life, with one chance and one mic to prove them that I'm one of a kind for just one night.
Toronto. Let's go, we're gonna make the turn or what?
Street team CEO, Tasman, you know what I mean? He's doing everything crazy in the streets. You wanna holler at him. He's the man right there, you know what I'm saying?
Hold back, son.
Where the whole BLAQ stands for, the Black August, you know, bars, lyrics, and quotables. We give you everything, you know what I mean? Yeah. We give you the catchy shit too, but it's crafted. It's not just, we're gonna repeat the same fucking word. We're gonna do something good. And if we do repeat one or two words, the shit that's in between there just...
crazy.
Out of this world.
I think the craziest part of that night is when the dude walked up and from the next crew and vouched for our homies on the stage. That was pretty funny.
Yo, you weren't lying.
What are you doing, bro? Hey,
claiming you a rider, rider, running like you wild, and when you come and you might find you on fire, fire, burning through the wire.
Who's the winner? Who's the winner?
Were granted the opportunity to open up for MLP because of your victory at the Two That Showdown.
We bring that energy as well, right? So it's almost like it's perfect for us.
You guys are gonna get a whole whiff of everything from party music to reality rap to fucking, yo, put you in your zone shit, yo. Put you in your place music. So come with that shit. Rooks, man, yo, he's just a ball of everything in one. He got like, he makes beats. I found out tonight that, wow, everything knocks. His rap style is unorthodox, similar to mine, I like it. His wordplay is just, you know, it's different. It's not the same as the usual out here. Everybody's trying to be somebody else, trying to fit in. And that's not really where, you know, what we're really trying to do out here. We're trying to be different. We're trying to stand out, we're trying to say something, you know what I mean? I like substance. I'm a fan of that. You catch my ear, I'm good to go. You rock with you at any level. I mean, it's just to be authentic, it gotta be real.
The life you talk about, you live in, but it ain't yours. The rap you spit and how you get it, you ain't made for. I don't care about the features that you paid for. So shut your mouth and get the fuck up on my face, cuz. The only magazine you ever held was Maxim. I'm proud to sleep. Put you trying to rap and it's kind of weak. You ain't fly with your lame ass.
Guarantee you play a card. I'm looking for Black August!
Oh,
straight up, we grind.
We gotta bring someone else. You might have seen this guy. I'm king of the dot, making all the wrong decisions. A big homie. Damn slow.
I'll do a track, but I know I gotta have my verse gotta be on point. So I wanna hear theirs first. They're both sick MCs, they're both really talented. They attack the MC game from a different angle. But at the same time, what they do together is the creation that people really need to take notice of and people really need to appreciate.
Together, they're hilarious, man. I'll be upstairs or something, and they'll yell at me to come down, jump on boards, let's go. You need to jump in the booth, let's get this done.
My one thing is honesty, and if I ask somebody to be honest with me and they're always honest with me, that's what it is. And you know what I mean? And that's what I like about Rooks. He's always honest. He's going to tell me something. He's not going to sugarcoat it. He don't like it. He don't like it. You know what I mean?
People really think I'm a fucking dick because I'm so strongly opinionated about certain things, but I just know what I want to sound like.
This is fucking crazy. Like, top to bottom, you could listen to this shit and just take yourself somewhere. Damn, yeah.
The point is, don't sleep on Black Ops.
You're kidding. And pillows better have no dents in it.
So you wrote his verse. It's not as good.
They got their shit together. Right? Anytime I've heard their music or anytime I've had to deal with them, when I've seen them live, it just seems like they're a band that actually rehearses. They're a group that rehearses and practices. And they just have their shit together. It seems like they have a focus. You know what I mean? And they're real serious about their music. So that makes them different in a way that other guys, they just want to be rappers and they don't really know how to handle themselves. So.
That's why you don't quit. You know, you just record the first one and say, yeah,
the last one, the layer, I was playing
on top. And if you do, you're a bitch.
It takes work. Perseverance. Lots of drugs.
Lots of drugs.
Like just stretch it out. Like back home, yeah, let's give it a shot.
Just to fill it out, it's your own discretion, really. You ready?
In the industry, they always talk about the it factor, and these guys have it, right? You just need to grind hard and keep developing it and believe in what you're doing. And get out there, man, network.
Killing it. Killing it. Killing it. It's like a motherfucking job. If you're not working, though, ain't gonna get here.
No. You're gonna stay where you are, sitting fucking at home eating fucking potato chips. Probably the worst fucking kind, too. The cheap kind of the
97, price. Yeah, the 97 cent kind. Yeah. Not the $1.50 kind. Black August, Brooks McCoy, Empty Clips, on the come up.
Yes, sir.
Support your fucking underground artists. Like,
it doesn't stop from Toronto to Oshawa. It doesn't stop just in that region. It's gonna go overseas.
It's everywhere.
Oceans, baby.
Yeah. Oceans.
Yeah, on yachts and bangs. Big yachts and bangs.
Yeah, it's plain and simple, and a great man once said, you know, Black August is killing it right now. And maybe one day, when you're good enough to pick up that microphone,
do it as good as us.
Do it as good as us. Maybe just one day you might kill him. Kill him with kindness or your raps. You got boss lyrics and quotables. It's Black August, you know. Come on.
Just make sure when you're on the way up, you're humble, because if you're not, don't burn bridges either. Black office all day, motherfucker.
That's what's up.